Welcome to Engineerdo. My name is Hendrik, and today I want to guide you through our approach on calibrating thermal models in DEM. We will be doing this in a DEM software called Liggghts. However, the approach is valid for all other DEM software as well. I will try to guide you through our approach on the calibration, which connects the measured values with the simulation world. Let's assume you want to simulate a heat conductivity process like a cooling screw for particles. The screw moves the particles along a cold wall, which takes the heat out of the bulk material. Hence, the heat loss is depending on the conductivity of the particles and the motion of the particles within the machine. For example, in a very well-mixed system, the process takes less time as in a motionless system. Therefore, we have to simulate the particle motion under consideration of the heat transfer of the particles within this machine. The heat transfer coefficient between the particles is the most important variable in this. The coefficient cannot be taken from literature values because of two reasons. First, in the simulation, we usually use a different grain size distribution. Larger particles may have less contacts, as if the voids between the particles are filled with smaller particles. So the contact area is less than what we would expect. Hence, the heat transfer coefficient in the simulation is larger than in real life to transfer the same amount of heat within less contact surface. Second, it is quite difficult to know your bulk material properties. If you don't use a standardized product, the grain size distribution, density and other material spec may have changed from the literature values. So, a measurement of the real heat transfer coefficient is necessary anyway. Now it is clear that we have to make an experiment to measure the bulk material heat conductivity to know the real physics of our specific bulk material. After this, we have to tune the simulation in a way to show the same behavior. That's called calibration. To start, let's take a closer look at the experimental setup. Imagine a simple sand-filled beaker placed in boiling water. As bulk material, I will use play sand from the sandbox. This setup needs three temperature sensors. One sensor overlooks the temperature of the boiling water to ensure a constant temperature level. The second sensor will be placed near the wall of the beaker. The third sensor will be placed in the center of the cylinder. The heat will transfer from the boiling water into the sand. The sensor will recognize the rising temperature first at the wall, and the third sensor in the middle will do the same but time delayed. The temperature of the water shall be constant at 373 Kelvin or 100 degrees Celsius. While this might seem straightforward, it was actually not that easy to get a system that measures three temperatures at once. Commercially available systems are quite complicated and use a lot of expensive components like platen sensors, data loggers, measurement software with the correct licensing and so on, which are way too expensive with around 1000 euros. That's the reason why we developed our own system that does not need any of this. To solve that issue, we have developed an innovative, cost-effective measurement system to record three different temperatures over the time. Our solution simplifies the process, reduces costs significantly, and is way more user-friendly. I placed one sensor in the water and two into the sand, one close to the perimeter, one in the middle of the structure. I measured the positioning with a meter stick. This is important to be able to transfer the measured results into the simulation. The system is designed to be modular and user-friendly, making it accessible to researchers and engineers. To start the measurement, I simply connect the measuring box with a USB cable for power supply. Then I log into the Wifi that the sensor box provides, where I can directly start a measurement or alternatively connect it to my home Wifi from where I can log into the measurement device and start the measurement, for example, from my desk PC. For the experiment, I found it more convenient to use my cell phone to start this measurement. After I'm done, I can directly download a CSV data table from the website of the device. For the visualization of the results, I simply use Excel. That was the easiest way I could imagine to measure more than one temperature over a long time span. If you like this prototype of a Wi-Fi-able temperature sensor, I built a little website where I can check out the specs of the tool and how the project is evolving over the time. With the experimental data in hand, the next step is to calibrate the DEM simulation in lights. We begin by setting up a terminal model that mirrors the real-world experiment, including the geometry of the beaker, the properties of the sand, and the initial and boundary conditions. The code for this terminal calibration I uploaded to Engineerdo.com. If we look into the code, we have, compared to a normal DEM simulation, only very minor changes to make. In the variables section, we define the thermal capacity of the material, TH cap, and the thermal conductivity, TH cont. The value for the thermal capacity for the sand I got from Wikipedia. The thermal conductivity will be changed until the temperature curves in the simulation meets the temperature curves from the experiment. This is called calibration. In line 126, I define the cylinder which contains the sand to have a temperature of 373 Kelvin, which equals to 100 degrees Celsius, the boiling point of water. In the lines 141 and 142, the variables defined above will be transferred to a property of the simulation. Note that the values must be given per atom type, which means separately for every material type we have in the simulation. In line 171, finally, the heat simulation is activated. The initial temperature of the particles is set to 279.15 Kelvin, which is equal to 6 degrees place sand temperature I got out of my backyard. In line 179, I also have to activate the writing of result files to see the temperatures in the result files. In this case, F underline temp in bracket 0 prints the data out of the temperature to a VTK result file. This can be visualized in ParaView later. The calibration process involves now the fine-tuning of the parameters of the thermal conductivity of the sand particles. The heat capacity of the particles I took from Wikipedia should fit for the sand. If you have a special bulk material, you may have to measure that as well. By comparing the simulation results with the measured temperature profiles, we interactively adjust these parameters until the simulation aligns closely with the experimental data. I think I've achieved here a very good fit of measurement to simulation. The experiment with two temperature sensors at different locations acts a bit also as a validation, since both curves must fit to each other. Once calibrated, the simulation provides a powerful insight into heat transfer dynamics with granular materials. This validated model can then be applied to a wide range of applications, from industrial drying processes to understanding terminal behavior in geological formations. And there you have it, a step-by-step guide to calibrating a DEM simulation with real-world terminal data. I hope you found this video helpful, and if you do, I would appreciate a thumbs up. If you want to learn more about DEM simulations and maybe also the coupling to CFD simulations, we have prepared two video courses on our webpage Academy. I will link this in the description below. Besides this, thanks for watching and see you next time.